in figure 1.44, x is any point in the interior of triangle. Point x is joined to the vertices of triangle. So we have xb, xe and xf. Segment PQ is parallel to DE. Segment QR is parallel to segment EF. Fill in the blanks to prove that segment PR is parallel to segment DF. So we have to prove that segment PR is parallel to DF. That's what we have to prove. Now in proof, let us try to prove it. In triangle XDE, so this is the triangle XDE. PQ is parallel to DE. Therefore, XP upon PD is equal to PQ upon XE. Please note this down, because the writing will go away now. Now let us draw the triangle DEF. X is any point inside the triangle, point X. PQ is parallel to DE, and QR is parallel to EF. QR is parallel to EF. We have to prove that PR is parallel to DF. Now let us try to put things together. In triangle XDE, since PQ is parallel to DE, therefore we have XP upon PD is equal to XQ upon QE. Applying basic proportionality theorem. Now in triangle XEF, where EF is the base, QR is parallel to EF. Therefore, we can write XQ upon QE is equal to XR upon RF. XR upon RF. From 1 and 2, this also applying basic proportionality theorem, BPT, we have this relation XQ upon QE is equal to XR upon RF. Now, QX upon QE is common in both the equations. Therefore, we can write xp upon pd is equal to xq upon qe. Is equal to XR upon RF. While writing, you need not write this one, the center stage. In those boxes, you can directly write this ratio, XR upon RF, in the boxes here. So, this is what we have proved. XP upon PD is equal to XR upon RF. So converse of basic proportionality theorem. By converse of basic proportionality theorem, we can say that PR is parallel to DE, which is what we are supposed to prove.